Likewise, when S is 0, then HS is undefined. When DS equal to 0, then HS is not defined. Rather, you can say HS tends to infinity in this case. So, DS is equal to 0 gives the poles of the system. Now, for any rational system function, the number of poles and zeros are equal if we include poles and zero even in infinite S planes, then they are equal. So now let's try to find out that for a system function how to find the poles and zeros. Say let's take problem number 9.5. For each of the following algebraic expression of the Laplace transform of a signal, determine the number of zeros located in the infinite S plane and number of zeros located at infinity. Say problem 1. It says this is 1 upon S plus 1 plus 1 upon S plus 3. If I simplify it, I get S plus 1 into S plus 3, and this is S plus 3 plus S plus 1. That means twice S plus 4 upon S plus 1 and S plus 3. So we have to find out determine the number of zeros located in the finite S plane and number of zeros located at infinity. Now, this is transform, Laplace transform of some signal x. Now, x of s will be 0 when this is 0. This gives s is equal to minus 2. So, we have got a 0 infinite s planes. That means value of s is finite. And x of s will be again 0 when s tends to infinity. You can divide numerator and denominator by s square. So this becomes 2 by s, 4 by s square. And if I divide by s, this becomes 1 plus 1 by s into 1 plus 3 by s. Now as s tends to infinity, this becomes 0, this becomes 0, this becomes 0, this becomes 0, 1 into 1. So this becomes 0 by 1. So s is equal to infinity is also a 0. So there are two zeros. This is a 0 in finite S plane. And this is a 0 at infinity. 0 at infinity. So let's take part B. Part B says this is x of s. You should always look for a pole zero cancellation. So this is s plus 1. This can be factorized as s plus 1 into s minus 1. This and this cancel. 1 upon s minus 1. So there is no finite zero. There is no finite zero. Zero. No zero in finite S plane. But if S tends to infinity, this becomes zero. So 1 0 at S is equal to infinity. For rest of the part, you can, you should try yourself, and if there be any problem, you can ask me. Let and the Laplace transform of dt is gs given to minus, or she is given to be this. L of s has to greater than minus 1. Then determine the values of constants alpha and beta. Determine the values of constants alpha and beta. Now let's try to find out Laplace transform of gt from here. Then this becomes gs x of s plus alpha x of minus s from time reversal property. And Laplace transform of x of s from here is beta s plus 1. Then let's try to find out gs from here. So gs now becomes beta upon s plus 1 plus alpha x of s now becomes beta 1 minus s. So let's simplify these two. This becomes 1 minus s square. If I take LCM, what we get is beta 1 minus s plus alpha beta into s plus 1. Now let's collect the coefficients beta into 1 plus alpha, constant term. This beta plus alpha beta. And then we have got S alpha beta minus beta upon minus S square minus 1. Now, if I compare these to GS, then there is no term, constant term here. This requires that this must be 0. Beta 1 plus alpha must be 0. And here, this would be minus 1. Because so, alpha beta minus beta, this would be minus 1. That means alpha minus 1 into beta should be minus 1. If I divide this by this, then you get alpha plus 1 upon alpha minus 1 must be 0. That means alpha plus 1 must be alpha minus 1. Alpha plus 1, sorry, this was alpha minus 1. This implies that alpha plus 1 must be 0. So alpha equal to minus 1. And if alpha equal to minus 1, then beta must be 0. Yeah, now let's take alpha minus 1 here. So minus, put alpha equal to minus 1, minus beta, that means minus 2 beta should be minus 1, then beta should be half. So we get alpha as minus 1, beta half. Let's take 9.15. Consider two right sided signals xt and yt. Consider two right sided signals xt and yt created through differential equations. By dt xt as minus of minus 2 yt plus delta t. This is 1 and by dt yt is twice of x, then the problem is determine ys and x of s along with their region of convergence. We have to determine what is ys, what is x of s, and their ROCs. All these three we have to determine. So let's take Laplace transform of both sides. Let's take Laplace transform both sides. So this, from if Laplace transform of x t is x of s, then Laplace transform this will become s x of s minus 2 y s, and Laplace transform delta t is 1. And from this equation we get s y s, this becomes twice x of s. Now we have to find out what is y s and what is x of s. From here we can find out x of s in terms of y s. So x of s now become 1 minus 2 y s by s. Let's substitute over here. Then s y s becomes twice x of s 1 minus 2 y s by s. Let's multiply here. So s square y s plus 4 y s equal to 2. So ys becomes 2 by s square plus 4. And then from here you can substitute ys here to determine what is x of s. So x of s becomes s by 2 into y s, 2 upon s square plus 4. That means 2s upon 2 will get cancelled. So s upon s square plus 4. And since both are right side the signals, the ROC for both the equals will be real of s greater than 0.